Okay, then, in terms of learning about the night sky in the last video, I left you with the idea of doing some star hopping to find things in the night sky and really look like an expert. But let me just sort of tell you how it works. Start going down that list. The first thing you always want to base yourself around is, of course, the Big Dipper. Maybe let me use some white here because we are talking about these stars after all. So I think the handle of the Big Dipper has sort of that 1, 2, 3, 4 stars, and then we get the bowl and it looks something like that. Okay, so if you can identify this, of course, you know your first star, how to find Polaris. You would just use the two pointer stars over here and go up from here and find Polaris. Okay, but there's a couple things now. Here's some new things for you that you can do. The first thing that you can do is also when you find the Big Dipper, and it sort of depends on how much of it you can see in the time of year, but you should definitely try to do this here. The first thing you can do in terms of your star top hopping is you can arc to Arcturas. Little thing you can remember, arc to Arcturas. So what happens when you arc to Arcturas is if you come over here on the handle of the Big Dipper, and this is our star hop, and you start here, and this sort of is in the shape of an arc, right? There's your arc part right there. You're gonna arc, and if you come over here like this, there's gonna be a orangish star right around here, and that orangish star is Arcturus. So you found something else on the list. You arced Arcturus. Again, and I hope you see how the star hopping technique really helps. The second thing that you do is then you spike to Spica. Of course, this is the star name. So once you've arced Arcturus, then what you do is you spike to Spica. So where maybe the arc was always sort of this curve that you were in here following the Big Dipper's handle, you're arcing to Arcturus. The spike to Spica, the spike implies something sort of straight like that. Indeed it is. You just spike straight down like this to another star, which is right here. It'll be definitely a little whiter than Arcturus. Whiter, and I mean in color, not wider, whiter. And this star here will be Spica. And so with that, you're doing quite well on the list, aren't you? So if you think about this now, if you can just possibly go pull this off, you can find the Big Dipper. You can find the North Star. You can arc to Arcturus, and you can spike to Spica. You are well in command of your night sky at this point. Two more. We can use the Big Dipper for. Might have a little trouble squeezing it on the slideshow, but I shall try, okay? If you go back to your bowl of the Big Dipper, and let me maybe highlight these handle stars a bit more so we can sort of see our Big Dipper once again. If you use the diagonal portions of the bowl like this, I'll maybe draw this in this blue line here. If you use the diagonal portions of the bowl and go like this and travel some distance out like that, you'll encounter two very whitish blue stars, maybe like one right here and one right here, and they might have a little bluish tinge to them, which I'll try to add in my artwork here like that, bluish white like that. These are the two stars of Castor, C-A-S-T-O-R, and Pollux, okay? The stars look very similar, so the first one will be Castor, the second will be Pollux. They look very similar. They're fairly bright in the sky, and these two stars are often in the Greek mythology or the astrology, which I always like to take a jab at, are definitely twin brothers because of their similarity in the sky. So I'll tell you a little more story about them. Actually, what happened here is Castor and Pollux, as the story goes, are twin half-brothers. And these are just wonderful campfire stories, right? You're trying to be a better camper. They're twin half-brothers because they have different fathers, which were Zeus. You probably all know about Zeus from Greek mythology. And Tyndaneus. But curiously, though, as the story goes, so twin brothers, different father, Zeus and Tyndaneus, but they came from the same egg. So I'm just telling you the story as it goes, and I don't know what to tell you. And as it went on from that, sort of in the story here, Castor was killed, and then Pollux then asked Zeus, so the remaining sort of half-brother, twin, whatever, to immortalize them by the knee. So he wanted to immortalize Castor, who was, of course, was killed with him. And of course, with him, I mean by Pollux, his son, his brother here, with him by the knees.
So immortalize him in the sky by the
knees. And they collectively then, Castor and Pollux in the sky, form the constellation Gemini. And so I think what we need to do now is take a tour of all this good stuff using Stellarium, the solar system simulator. So we're going to go, I'm going to show you the Big Dipper. I'm going to arc to Arcturus. I'm going to spike to Spica. I'm going to come down here and show you Castor and Pollux, and I'll turn on the constellation arch so you can see the two brothers in the sky like that, and then we'll go from there. Just a few closing comments now. I just wanted to point out that here you go with Arcturus. So when you have the Big Dipper and you arc to Arcturus, this is what you're sort of getting to, this huge star here, which is much, much larger than our sun. So keep that in mind. And lastly, on this map right here, which we sort of discussed how you can start from your Big Dipper here and find all kinds of things with star hopping. I hope now that you have a pretty decent answer to question number 37, which says, impress your friends and family. How do you find Arcturus, Spica, the North Star, Cassiopeia, starting with the Big Dipper, of course. So we should have a pretty good plan for that question as well.